All those numbers, when numbers are there, there's this scary thing called taxation. I mean, it's a very complex subject. But that's why we have experts today who can simplify that for us a bit. So we have Gauri Gokhale from Nishit Desai, who will take us to the next session on taxation.
Plan to do this in this session is to discuss how the payment system works, how the taxation works when you look at the online platforms, and we keep getting these queries, especially when you have a downloadable app, when you make the payment, how is the payment flow happening, who's going to pay the taxes, am I required to pay the taxes, or are the gamers going to pay the taxes? And the other interesting thing is when you look at the cross-border issues. For example, you put your app or the game on the app store, and where is the payment going, and whether it's the legal method in which the payments are being made. So in the Indian context, I think last year or year before last, we had discussed the IP issues in the gaming sector. So what we try to do every year is to discuss newer aspects and newer issues that we come across. So just a quick glance on which are the various laws that get applicable whenever you are putting your game, whether on mobile, whether on internet. You have telecom laws, you have IP laws, you have obscenity laws in India, you have taxation laws, you have personality rights issues. Just in the earlier presentation, you saw when a particular star is incorporated in your game, there could be personality rights issues. You have to take certain rights or licenses from these personalities. So, there are several legal issues that one has to look into. When you are very creative people, sometimes you may not realize that when you plan things, as was discussed in the earlier session, you need to plan keeping in mind all these other four walls within which you need to operate. And when I say four walls, I mean the walls within of the law that you need to operate. Now, for example, now what are the issues that we typically face in this particular industry? Now, whenever you have a player in India, suppose keep yourself in the shoes of the player rather than the game developers for a second. So if you are a player, you are making payment and you want to play poker, right? And you find that this is particular foreign website, and you want to make dollar payments, and you go ahead and make those payments. Is that something right? Is that something legal? And the answer is no, unfortunately. Because when you make the payment from India on these gambling websites especially, and there are certain gaming websites also which will fall within the purview of this law, that you actually cannot remit your money from India to any foreign entity, because that is prohibited under the law. Now, suppose you have earned any royalties, or you have earned any lotteries or otherwise, again the payments are prohibited outside of India. Now imagine a situation that you are looking into the payment processing issue. You tie up with a foreign game operator, and you say that I will do your marketing in India, and let us tie up with the payment processor for the payments to be made to you directly, and whoever plays within India, the payment will be made directly to your foreign partner, and you are doing only the marketing activity in India. Now that also is not allowed, because all these payment processing entities, you must be knowing about CC Avenue and some of these PayPal, etc. Under the current law, they are not allowed to accept the foreign game developers as their clients. So what happens, typically what we have seen is, then the Indian party will have to act as an agent and accept that money on their behalf and then do the remittance. Now there are certain tax issues also that may come into play because of this. So what I'm trying to tell you is, everything is not so simple that it appears on the internet, that you simply put your credit card details and make the payments. There are several laws that you may or may not be violating or not complying. So the other issue that recently we have faced is the virtual currency, Right? Now, there are two different things here. When you say a virtual currency, the player may actually have paid money to obtain that currency. Or the second possibility is when the player has done certain action because of which you have allotted him that virtual currency. Right? So there also there are certain laws that get triggered. Now the Reserve Bank of India, which controls, you know, the entire monetary system within India, has actually reserved, issued an advisory against use of the virtual currency, especially when you have paid for it. Now when you are creating a e-wallet, as we call it, right? You're creating a, oops, this is dangerous. So you're creating an e-wallet. So suppose somebody has paid cash and you create an e-wallet for them to play on your, on your application. Again, there is some law that gets triggered. There are certain compliances that get triggered. So suppose you ask me that I have created this e-wallet and, the player has put in 100 rupees. The 50 rupees, cash has already been exhausted. Now the player, can I pay that 50 rupees back to the player, in his bank account? And the answer is no, because you are creating what is called as a closed loop system, and within that you are not allowed to pay cash back. What the player needs to do is exhaust entire 100 rupees on your, application. So these are some of the issues that we currently face, and I want to stop here for the moment, and actually because we have limited time, I want to first ask you on what are these payment related or tax issues, that you have in mind that you want answers to, and then next 15-20 minutes we will quickly, walk through certain scenarios which we have come across and how in those scenarios the taxation system works. My colleague Ashish will, walk you through those. So if I could have some questions, yes.
The most obvious one is that if I'm getting paid by Google or Apple, what about that money? Is that you have to pay tax in India for that?
Sure.
How does that work? That would seem to be the most obvious question.
Sure. So we will, deal with that. Any other question? Yes. Right. So freelancer, they create IP and you need to make remittances. We actually have that one example in our slide. Yes?
Like you just said, if I pay my credit card.
Right.
I may or may not be knowing. Okay, I am doing some mistake.
Correct. Correct.
Who will be punished? Because money has already gone from my credit.
So, quickly to answer you, you are liable personally for that, and we'll deal with that slightly later. But
is there any warning come from that?
No. So, credit card typically, to answer your question here and now, is when the credit card agencies have been issued an advisory by the Reserve Bank of India that the remittances from India to the foreign websites which are operating these gaming or otherwise, these type of websites, you cannot make those payments. But sometimes what happens is there are certain other methods that we have come across by which people actually make the payment. So then it becomes little tricky because you as a player should be aware, and you cannot feign ignorance of law.
It should not be.
That is the credit card agency's lookout, actually. Yeah.
How I become a...
No, it is your liability, but for the enforcement purpose, they also have been given advisory. That is the way it works. Yeah.
Ad network payments.
Sorry?
Ad
network payments in euros and dollars, how do we deal with, that? Yes?
With reference to taxation purposes, is there any difference between selling an app upfront, virtual goods, and taxation on advertisements?
Sure.
Like advertisement earnings?
Sure.